Hello students, welcome back to online class. Dear students, you know very well that already in my previous class I have completed geography first chapter, that is the earth in the solar system. And after the explanation of that chapter, I sent the notes through the WhatsApp, and I hope each and everyone has written the question answers. And today I am here for the discussion of question answers. So dear students, here three bits are there. The first bit is answer the following questions, and the second bit is tick the correct answers, and the third one is fill in the blanks. So first we are going to discuss the first bit, that is answer the following questions. Okay, so in that, the first question is, how does a planet differ from a star? What is the question, children? How does a planet differ from a star? So already in my explanation, I said you, what do you mean by planet and what do you mean by star? So if you heard carefully my explanation, so you can answer this question. Okay, now let me write answer. What is that question, children? How does a planet differ from a star? It means, what are the differences between the stars and planets? Okay, let us see. Stars are big and hot. Stars are big and hot celestial bodies. Made up of gases. They have their own heat and light. Own heat and light. Planets are also celestial bodies, but they do not have their own heat and light. They are lit by the stars. They are lit by the stars. Okay, see you, children. What is the question? How does a planet differ from a star? How the planet is different from a star? What is the answer? Stars are big and hot celestial bodies made up of gases. Already I said in my explanation. Stars are celestial bodies, and stars are very big and hot. They have their own heat and light. Stars are having their own heat and light. But planets don't have their own heat and light. See it, children? Planets are also celestial bodies, but they do not have their own heat and light. They lit by the stars. Understood, children? Once again, let me read the answer. Stars are big and hot celestial bodies made up of gases. They have their own heat and light. Planets are also celestial bodies, but they do not have their own heat and light. They are lit by the stars. This is the difference between a planet and a star. in examination, if the question comes, how does a planet differ from a star? Easily you can answer for this question. And before also in my explanation, I said you about this. Is it clear, children? Have you understood the question number one and as well as answer? Okay. Now let's go for the second question. Already, just now we have discussed question number one and its answer. And now we are going to discuss question number two or B. You can say B or two. What is meant by the solar system? What is meant by the solar system? This is question number two. What is the question? What is meant by the solar system? Or what do you mean by the solar system? This also already we have discussed in the previous class. What do you mean by solar system? So let us see the answer. Okay. Answer. The sun, eight planets, satellites, and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteorites form the solar system. Okay. This is the answer of question number two. So what is question? What is meant by the solar system? It means, what do you mean by the solar system? Answer is very simple. The sun, eight planets, satellites, and some celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteorites form the solar system. In my previous class, already we have discussed what do you mean by asteroids and as well as what do you mean by meteorites. So this is the second answer. Let me revise once again. The question number two is, what do you mean, what is meant by the solar system? And the answer is the sun, eight planets, satellites, and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteorites form the solar system. Understood, children? This is question number two and its answer. Already I said to you, children, if you heard the lesson carefully, you can answer all the questions. Now we are going to discuss question number three or C. So what is that? Name all the planets. Name all the planets. Name all the planets according to their distance. Distance from the sun. This is question number three. So what is that? name all the planets according to their distance from the sun. So in my previous class I have shown you one chart which was related to planets, and I have said about the distance also. So here you are going to write all the planets' names, but you should be very careful. According to their distance you have to write. And also children, I said you one line. If you know that line, if you know that sentence, easily you can say all the planets' names. Can anybody tell children what was that sentence? My very efficient mother just served us nuts. If you know the sentence, you can say all the planets' names according to their distance. So now I am going to write the answer. In order to their distance from the sun, eight planets are first one Mercury, Venus, Earth, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and last one is Neptune. See children, this is the answer for the third question. In order to their distance from the sun, eight planets are Mercury. Mercury is the first nearest planet to the sun. And second one is Venus. Third one is Earth. Earth is the third nearest planet to the sun. Fourth one is Jupiter. Fifth one is Saturn. So Uranus and Neptune. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. So this is the answer. Okay, the question is very simple, and as well as the answer also very simple. Next, after the third question and as well as answer, we are going for the next question. Fourth question, or you can say question number D. So what is that fourth one question? Why is the Earth called unique planet? Why is the Earth called unique planet? Can anybody say, children, before writing the answer? Why is the Earth called unique planet? See children, there are eight planets, but only the Earth is called unique planet. Why? What is the answer? Regarding this also, already we have discussed in the previous class. Because the Earth has water, air, oxygen. Because of this reason, the Earth is called, what is that? Unique planet. Because water, air, these are the very essential for the survival. Let me write the answer. Earth has water and air, which are very essential for the survival. The air has life supporting gases like oxygen. Because of these reasons, Earth is called unique planet. Got it, children? The answer is very simple. Earth has water and air, which are very essential for the survival. Let me tell you, without water and air, can we survive, children? No, it's not possible. So, Earth has water and air, which are very essential for the survival. The air has life supporting gases like oxygen. Because of these reasons, the Earth is called unique planet. Got it? Okay. So, we have discussed them. Question number 4, and as well as the answer of that. So now, question number 5, or you can say E. So what is that? Why do we see always one side of the moon? Why do we see always one side of the moon? This is the question. Understood, children? What is that question number E? Why do we see always one side of the moon? Let me get the answer. The moon moves around the earth. The moon moves around the earth. In about 27 days, it takes same time to complete one spin. It takes same time to complete one spin. As a result, we see one side of the moon. Or one side of the moon visible. Okay, see, children. Question number E. Why do we see always one side of the moon? The answer is very simple. The moon moves around the sun in about 27 days. The moon takes 27 days to complete one spin. It takes some time to complete, same time to complete one spin. As a result, we see one side of the moon or one side of the moon visible. Is it clear, children? This is question number E and answer. Let me revise once again. The moon moves around the earth in about 27 days. It takes same time to complete one spin. As a result, we see one side of the moon. This is the answer. So already we have discussed question number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or you can say A, B, C, D, E. So last, but not the least, only one question is remaining. So what is that question? What is that last question? What is universe? The last question is, what is universe? So regarding this also, already we have discussed in the previous class. So what is the question? What is universe? So let me write the answer of this question. A huge, or you can write like this also, a galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars and clouds of dust and gases. Millions of such galaxies, millions of such galaxies make the universe. Okay, see children, this is the last question. What is universe? So what is the answer? A galaxy is a huge system of billions of stars and clouds of dust and gases. Millions of such galaxies make the universe. So these are the six questions and as well as answers just now we have discussed. So the first bit is over. We have discussed all the question answers. So, first bit over. Next, we are going to the second bit, that is correct or tick the correct answer. Multiple choice questions are here. Three options are there and we have to tick which is the correct answer. Okay, second bit is tick the correct answer. What is that second bit, children? Tick the correct answers. So here A, B, C, D, E, five questions are there and in each question three options given. So out of these three options you have to tick which is the right answer. Okay, so what is that? Question number one or A, the planet known as the Earth's twin is. What is that question? The planet known as the Earth's twin is. Three options are there. First one is Jupiter, second one is Saturn, third one is Venus. So out of these all three options you have to tick which is the right one. So the first answer is Venus. What is that, children? The first answer is Venus. Okay. Second, B, which is the third nearest planet to the sun? You know very well already. We have discussed in the previous class also. Today also we have discussed about that. So which is the third nearest planet to the sun? Three options are here: Venus, Earth, and Mercury. Can anybody say, children, which is the right answer? Yes, you are right. That is Earth. So second answer is question number C or question number third one. All the planets move around the sun in a dash. So three options are here: circular path, rectangular path, elongated path. So which is the right answer? The right answer is elongated palm. Elongated palm. Fourth one. The pole star indicates the direction to the, regarding pole star also we have discussed it. Direction to the option A, south, option B, north, option C, east. Which is the answer? Very simple. The answer is north. So the fourth answer is north. And last one, asteroids are found between orbits of option A, Saturn and Jupiter, option B, Mars and Jupiter, option C, Earth and Mars. So which is the right answer here? The right answer is Mars and Jupiter. Mars and Jupiter. Okay. See children, these are the answers of second bit. Second bit is tick the correct answer. So the first question answer is Venus and second one answer is Earth. Third one answer is elongated part. Fourth one answer is North and fifth one answer is Mars and Jupiter. This is about second bit. So understood children, we have discussed already about first bit and as well as second bit. The last bit, what is that? The last bit is fill in the blanks. What is that? Fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. So here also, five fill in the blanks are here. The first one is a group of dash forming various patterns is called a dash. So here two dashes are there. A group of dash. So what you have to write there? Stars. What you have to write? Stars. A group of stars forming various patterns is called a dash. What is that? Constellations. So already I said you in first one two dashes are there. First you have to write star. First in the fill in the blank you have to write stars, and second fill in the blank is there. Now there you have to write constellation. This is first one. Second one, a huge system of stars is called dash. Can anybody guess what is the answer? Let me read one more time that question. A huge system of stars is called dash. The answer is galaxy. The answer is galaxy. And third one, what is that third question? Dash is the closest celestial body to the earth. In my previous class, this also already we have discussed. Dash is the closest celestial body to the earth. So what is the answer? Yes, absolutely you are right. The moon is the closest celestial body to the earth. So the answer is the moon. Fourth one, what is that? Dash is the third nearest planet to the earth. While discussing question answers, already I said you about that. Dash is the third nearest planet to the earth. What is that answer? Which is the third planet, nearest planet to the sun? The answer is very simple. That is Earth. Earth is the right answer. So in that place, you have to write Earth. And last one, planets don't have their dash and dash. What is that answer? Very simple. Planets do not have their own heat and light. So what is the answer, children? Heat and light. See, children, planets do not have their dash and dash. So what is the answer? Planets don't have their own heat and light. So the answer is heat and light. So these are the three bits, children. The first bit, which is related to the question answers. There are six questions, A, B, C, D, E, F, and already we have discussed all the questions and as well as answers. And second bit, it's related to the MCQs like tick the correct answer. That also we have discussed. And third bit, that is fill in the blanks. So here also five questions are there. So we have discussed about that also. So in this class, we have discussed all the three bits. So now question answers, tick the correct answers and fill in the blanks. All these three bits became very easy for you. And dear children, after writing the question answers in your notes, once you go through the notes, once you go through the textbook, then only you will get the complete knowledge of this chapter. And very soon we are going to conduct the test. So be careful. So you just you go through the notes and as well as go through the textbook. So we will meet in the next class. Thank you.